हरे कृष्णा, वी आर गोइंग टू सिंग अ सॉन्ग टुडे। जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी यशोद नंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना केरावन चारी। हरि बोल। चेंज दिस बॉक्स।
जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी। यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना केरावन चारी। यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन यमुना तेरावन चारी। नंदन व्रज जन हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे राम राम हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। गोविंद जय जय गोपाल जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय जय राधा रमण हरि गोविंद जय 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 गोविंद जय गोपाल जय गोविंद जय गोपाल केशव माधव दीनदयाल केशव माधव दीनदयाल जय गोविंद जय गोपाल केशव माधव दीनदयाल केशव माधव दीनदयाल। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम जय श्री वृंदावन धाम गोविंद गोविंद गोपाल नंदलाल गोविंद गोविंद गोपाल नंदलाल गोविंद गोविंद गोपाल नंदलाल गोपाल नंदलाल गोपाल नंदलाल राधे राधे श्याम श्याम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 राम 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 कृष्ण बल राम जय वृंदावन धाम कृष्ण बल राम जय वृंदावन धाम कृष्ण बल राम जय वृंदावन धाम हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम पावन हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र की श्रील प्रभुपाद की गौर भक्त वृंद की श्रीमद्भागवतम की ओम अज्ञानति विरांदस्य ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः वन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः श्री चैतन्य मनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूप कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदांतिकं वंदेहं श्रीगुरुः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगण रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च नमो ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशधारिणे नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण। सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू डिवोटीज। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी डिड द क्लाइमैक्स द पिनाकल ऑफ अवर उत्कर्ष कैंप विच इज कॉल्ड एज द स्पिरिचुअल वर्ल्ड प्लेस ऑफ मेरिट एंड मेरी। You heard about the Madhurya Rasa, Krishna and the Gopis, very elaborately we discussed it. Now after we complete all these topics which you all have been hearing steadily, especially I congratulate all of you who have been making an effort to be present more than 80% of the classes. I know you have your college studies and exams coming up, and you all have been very patiently coming and showing your enthusiasm in learning this very important spiritual subject matter, which can actually lead you to liberation from this world. You get liberated from this world, go back home, back to God at once and for all. So after learning all these things, now comes the most important thing which we are going to discuss today and tomorrow in these sessions. What is it? When after having learned all this knowledge, you need a setting in order to be able to put this knowledge into practice. Otherwise, what's the use? Simply theoretical knowledge will evaporate from our heads if you don't put it in action. Just like in your college, the morning part of the day, you sit and hear the theory. In the afternoon part, after lunch, you go to the lab where you do practical, isn't it? Just as in the field of science, you have theory and practice. Similarly, in the path of spirituality also, you find philosophy and religion. Philosophy is the theory you hear, and religion is the practice. So in order for us to be able to practice this wonderful knowledge which you have heard, we need ambience, we need association, we need the facilities for that. So regarding that, we are going to talk today. You can see the PowerPoint here. So the students, they need training in a balanced lifestyle for all-round successful life. What is that balance? We all need a balance between spiritual life and material life. Like you all are students, you need to study well and score well. Many of our students who came to our centers, student centers, they came with 7th grade or something. But after they came to our center, they started getting 9.2, 9.3 grade. The reason is they gave up all the bad habits. They have late night, and sleeping in the day also, sleeping in the night also, and roaming with friends for movies, going to hotels, or sometimes watching IPL for 8 hours a day. Some people had a habit of watching 2-3 Hindi movies in a day. There were boys like that. And some boys had even other bad habits like smoking and drinking also. But once they came to the student center, their whole lifestyle underwent a drastic change, radical change, which is what you will learn in today's session. This is about the Jet Age Gurukul. What is Jet Age Gurukul? I will say a little bit about the traditional Gurukul as well as the Jet Age Gurukul. Vaibhav Prabhu, have they seen the video of the Gurukula, Mayapur Gurukul, they have seen? They have seen, so when I talk, it'll make sense to them. Okay, let us go through this PowerPoint and then we will talk more. See, if a student wants a bright future, he has to cultivate these values: personal values, interpersonal values, social values, and spiritual values. Now, what are the personal values? Personal values are values like integrity, first of all. See, if a man lacks integrity, he's good for nothing. I'll give you examples for each of the qualities that I will tell you now, so that you will see its relevance in your life. Like one IT fellow was working in a company. The rival company saw that this company is making great strides up. They're going to make very big profits, crores of rupees. So the rival company met this man and said, "Hey, if you can release some of the secrets from your company, for one secret, we'll give you 1 lakh. they said. So this man was already drawing 12 lakhs per annum, which means approximately 1 lakh per month he was getting already. Now he thought, if I release one secret, they'll give me one lakh. So he released 6 secrets in 1 year. So now how much he earned? 18 lakhs totally. 18 lakhs he earned that year. And he got used to it. Now he told them, don't worry. As and when we make progress in our project, I'll keep supplying you. And you keep giving me money. He thought, I'll become a millionaire like this. Then what happened in the second year? This parent company started seeing that the rival company is skyrocketing. And we are nosediving. Why is that? They were very shocked. Whatever plans we make, those guys are implementing. Plans we are making in our theoretical notebook and they are implementing it. So they got very suspicious. Somebody is leaking out everything. And at last this black sheep was caught. They really fired him. They threw him out of the job with a lot of chastisements and black marks and everything. Anyway, this fellow was a shameless fellow. He had no integrity. So, honesty means to say what you will do. Integrity means to keep your promise. So, everybody working in a company should be loyal to the company. He was not loyal. So, when he was thrown out of the company, he laughed it off. He said that anyway, I was in a good job till now. Now, any other company I can join. So, but when he tried to join other companies, every company will call up the parent company and they came to know he was black marked. And nobody was ready to take him. So 2 to 3 years, he could not get a good job. Even anywhere he tried to join, they threw him out. They were not ready to take him because they knew reference of the previous company. So you can imagine now 2 years he lost salary means how much? 2 into 12 lakhs? 24 lakhs he lost. He earned 6 lakhs but lost 24 lakhs. Is it not penny wise, pounds foolish? Then at last he came to the rival company and said, sirs, you know, now I am practically broken down. It is because of you. You know, I have been thrown out from my parent company. Can you please take me? They showed the door and said, get lost. We can't allow you because you are a traitor. You cannot be trusted. Just as you cheated that company, you may also cheat us. We don't want you. So he had to run from pillar to post for some job. At last he got one mediocre job, paying him 30,000-40,000 rupees in some unknown company, private company. So why I'm telling you this true story? Because if you don't have integrity, if you have a cheating tendency, in the long run, we'll be failure. For short term, we can be successful. I have one video which will take 45 minutes to show. Therefore, I will not show the video, but I'll tell you. There were two students. One student, he saw that the sir had given him, 40 marks. But actually, he understood he had committed some mistakes. He only deserved 30 marks. He went to the sir and showed, sir, you have given me 40 marks. Actually, I have committed mistakes. You have given marks unknowingly. So the sir cut down that and then made it 30. He said, oh, that means you have failed in this paper. So you have to rewrite this exam. Plus, you have to also do additional homework for failing in the exam. He said, okay, sir, I will do that, sir. He went and sat. So another boy laughed at him and said, what a fool you are. If I were you, I would have kept the 40 marks with me. Why should I go and show to sir and reduce the marks? On the other hand, this boy said, see, now I have one blank paper in my paper. I will add some more things and add more marks. So he copied from one of his friends. Sir, this question is not corrected by you. And the sir corrected and then said, 24 marks. So he got 60. He got first class. He came and said, see, my friend, this is my smartness. Look at you, what a fool you are and how smart I am. Jamana badal gaya. Jamana ke anusar chalna padta hai duniya mein. Like that he was telling. But the other friend Pavitra, his name is Pavitra. Pavitra was very honest. He said, no. No matter how the world changes, ultimately God is a witness. We can't flourish with cheating propensity, he said. Then what happened when the final exams came? This copying boy saw the paper was very big and he was taking his friend's paper and writing. And sir came, he gave it back. Sir said, hey, what are you doing? You are looking at your friend's paper and everything. He said, no, sir. No, I didn't do anything, sir. He said, once he spared him. The second time, the sir went on round and came and saw this boy was copying again. He had totally taken the paper of somebody and copying it from there. Sir caught him from the collar behind. Immediately debarred him, threw him out of the exam. And Then the school called both the parents. So the Pavitra's parents came, and Pavitra actually had steadily progressed, worked very hard, and became a meritorious boy because he followed integrity. His speech had some weight; it carried some weight. He was truthful. He was honest. He was a man of integrity. So he went on to become a great entrepreneur. The other boy who was copying, his mother was called by the college school principal and said, "See, your son has several times been caught copying like this. Now we are debarring him 1 year. He has to repeat again this full standard again." So in the long run, you will see people who adopt foul means they cannot flourish. You will see that. So I told you one corporate example, one school example. Both I have told you. You can see that. So personal value means like integrity, truthfulness, honesty, simplicity, straightforwardness. These are the qualities which you possess as an individual. This is your composition of your personality. And for example, patience, and for example, tolerance. You will see Pandavas, you know, their wife was insulted in the public assembly. They were put in the Varana but Lakshagriha, and a live attempt was made to burn them alive. The Bhima was fed with poison. They were driven away to jungle by foul means, by cheating them through gambling match. But you will see Pandavas never thought any suicidal thoughts. Never in this, because Krishna, they were always remembering Krishna. So they had such tolerance and such patience to finally fight the Dharma Yuddha and become kings of the whole world. You will find, on the other hand, nowadays you find boys are so weak-minded. In IIT Hyderabad, I was telling you, three boys committed suicide within 1 year, 2019. That means, you know, modern day youths are very weak-minded because they don't have that kind of tolerance, that kind of patience. Like we say, you know, when the going gets tough, the tough get going. That is Pandavas. Yeah, you can see that. Similarly, another individual quality is, it's called as thrift, we call it. Thrift means what? Not unnecessarily spending money. You can call if you want kanjus. Actually, in India, you will see parents and grandparents and all how they have lived in that. Like, for example, if they use a, for example, use the t-shirt, it has become torn, they will stitch it and they will use it. If it again becomes torn somewhere else, they'll take it out, they'll use it for cleaning after the food is over. They will use it as a cloth for cleaning. You will see that. And then afterwards, it becomes even more worse. Then they'll put it in the feet somewhere. Until it completely becomes good for nothing. You will see that. Similar toothpaste also. In India, nobody will just take like this. They will finish up to the end, squeeze it. They will not even leave it. Also, you've seen that? Yeah. So once Gandhi lost a pencil, he told his assistant, "Get me my pencil." That fellow got a new one and sharpened and gave. Gandhi said, "I want the old one." And the servant said, "Sir, it was only this much." He said, "No, I want that only." So both master and servant searched. After 1 hour, they found that small pencil inside a file. So it's called thrift. So not unnecessarily wasting God's energy. Similarly, you're not wasting the light, not wasting the fan, not wasting the water. Once Prabhupada was walking in a farmhouse, if we're going to the farm, he saw the tap was open unnecessarily, and the bucket was overflowing. And Prabhupada took some trouble to go there and then switch off the tap. So Prabhupada said, "This is Krishna's energy. We shouldn't waste it." So these are individual qualities, personal values, what you have in your life, how you spend your things. Your father is sending you money. Just because father is sending money, don't lavishly spend the money. You very carefully spend. And if you save the money, father will be happy. Tomorrow, when you become an earning man, you will know how valuable is money. You will be very careful in releasing the money at that time. So, therefore, we all need personal values. Like what I told you now, integrity, honesty, truthfulness, tolerance, simplicity, patience, enthusiasm. These are all individual qualities, personal values. Then, interpersonal values. What are the interpersonal values? When you are dealing with others, we should respect others. We should respect even an ant. What to speak of respecting other boys, respecting our teachers, respecting parents, respecting God, respecting saintly people, respecting women. So we need to deal with other people with respect. If you respect, from respect, many, many good qualities come. When you are respectful to people, naturally you are grateful for whatever you receive from them. You have admiration for them, you have appreciation for them, gratitude for them, your obedience to your superiors. And you will not insult them unnecessarily. You will not mock at them or ridicule them. You will not make a joke out of them. All good qualities will come just by this one quality of respect. Nowadays you find Prabhupada says the children, boys are giving headaches to their parents. Prabhupada says, how they give headache? You know, your boy is sent to college for study. Except study, he will do everything. He will roam with girls in the bike. He will smoke cigarette. He will drink liquor. He will take to drugs. Then father will be worried. He will go to the director and the warden and say, sir, my son is getting spoiled. Why are you not taking care? And the warden will say, kusi ko sunta nahi, manmani karta hai. So the children are giving headaches to parents. Actually, father is sending money for him to study, but he's misusing that money, squandering that wealth. Because they have no respect for the father. They have no respect for grandfather also. In those days, when an old man is coming in the road, if some boy is smoking cigarette, immediately he'll throw it away. He'll be afraid. Because he will, and because he knows that old man will come to me and give me some upadesh. Aisa nahi karna chahiye, achcha nahi, tambaku nahi karna chahiye, he will say. So he will immediately be very careful. In fact, boys will take mukwas also. Put something in the mouth so that he will not come with a bad smell to home. But nowadays, boys are smoking on the face of the grandfather. They have no fear at all. Shameless. Completely. Yeah. So, in this way, the interpersonal values, interpersonal clashes are increasing. Every boy wants to be a hero and they catch the collar and slap the other boys physically also. They become angry. They can't control their emotions. They become lusty, they become angry, they become greedy, and they do atrocities interpersonal in dealing with others. So, Shastra says that if somebody is senior to you, you should be jolly to receive them. Somebody is equal to you, you should be friendly with them. Somebody junior to you, you should be compassionate to them. And people just do the opposite. If somebody is senior to me, people become envious of them. Why should he be respected? I know better than him. Like that. Somebody is equal, they brag about their own achievements. Somebody is junior, they ridicule them, mock at them, rag them, ragging, isn't it? Just because some boy has joined newly, they go and rag him. So, you see, these are things to be noticed in the modern day society. Similarly, social values actually means, you know, do you ever think about the cow, how the cows are being slaughtered, or how the cows are not fed proper food? Are you concerned and worried about the youth of India? You know, out of 150 crore, you know, more than 65 or 70 crore is youths in India. And the youth is getting degraded because there are some unscrupulous people who are actually coming and giving drugs to Indians, especially to Punjabis, I heard. Why they're giving to Punjabis? Because if the Punjabis eat drugs, they can't become soldiers in the Indian army. And if they become eat drugs and they completely lose their potency, strength and everything, and then the Indian army strength will be reduced. And when that army strength is reduced, then the countries who are envious of India can take over. See what all they are doing. And for this, they are bringing huge quantity of drugs are entering into India in a secret manner and they are selling. So one of our devotees in Pune called Toshanya Mahaprabhu, he has written a book on drug addiction. And how India can be saved from drug addiction. That book is going, you know, in thousands and lakhs, that book is going now. All over the country, we are trying to create awareness for the youth. So we should be worried about youth of India. You know, if you don't protect the youth, they are going to become a slave of the drugs and they will become like bone. Only bones will remain. Drug will eat them up. Their whole life will be ruined. So social value means you are concerned about youth of India. You are concerned about culture of India. You are concerned about protecting the values and culture of India, Indian heritage. You are also concerned about the cows. You are also concerned about dharma. You also worry about, you know, the direction which the world is taking now. So then you have social values. And the spiritual values, you have been learning regularly. Spiritual values means our relationship with God. And our understanding of God is very deeply given in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, which you all have been learning also. So we have to build all these values for a bright future. Now I'm going to show this slide, so it will be easy for you to catch what I'm going to talk now. See here, these are the qualities of a good student. Now one by one, let's go. See in the top, self-discipline. Please read those four qualities.
Self-discipline, self-control, self-respect, good manners.
Yeah. So self-discipline means, you know, time per kana, time per sona, time per utana. Self-discipline. You know, when you get up in the morning, rinse your mouth, brush your mouth, take a bath after passing stool, and wear fresh dress in the morning. So these are all the bodily disciplines, isn't it? Then you can have discipline in your studies also, in your college studies. If one period is off, don't waste time gossiping with boys. Go to library. Immediately 1 hour solidly you can make study. So right now your duty is academics and spirituality, like a railway line. This should be your goal right now. So be disciplined in that. Disciple, word comes from discipline. Disciple means he is obedient and he adheres to the discipline that he plans out. You have a time management plan you have made. Morning I will do this, afternoon I'll do this, evening I'll do this. I'm not boasting or exaggerating. In our college in engineering days, we had three of us who will always be in the first three ranks. Sometimes I'll come first, other two will be, sometimes I'll come third and they will be first, second. We will not waste 1 minute, I can tell you, in the college days. In the night also, we used to study till about 10, 10:30, 11, we used to study. We used to sit in the terrace. We had a chair, we had a pad, and spread the books and underline and make first class notes, and we'll exchange the notes also. I'll make best notes and give them, and they'll give the best notes, give me different subjects. So we are super enthusiastic. You can even call us mad also. We were mad to the point of, you know, mathematics means you should get centum. Many subjects we try to get 98, 99 marks. So in strength of materials, such kind of subjects, and certain subjects, we would try to get a centum. So actually, student means you have to be super enthusiastic to study. Why should we be lazy? Otherwise, why did you join college? Did you join college to do time pass? We should be very enthusiastic. Anything you take up in life, you should be enthusiastic. You are taking Krishna consciousness. Get up in the morning, take bath, come and dance very enthusiastically. Chant and chant to the beach, take prasad with devotees, and bow down to Krishna with respect in your mind. So do it well. In the same manner, if you are a student, you should be very enthusiastic for studying. You know, and you should try to top, get very good marks, get grade like 9.5, 9.8. You should aim like that. So otherwise, what else your father expects from you immediately? You know, he is sending you money regularly every month. Actually, other activities which are doing extracurricular activities, watching TV, you know, watching cricket and going for movie, all these things. Some boys actually while away the time so much in those activities, the main activities of us, isn't it? So therefore, we need discipline. We have to, if you don't discipline your body and mind, they are going to go in the wrong directions. And then second one is self-control. Self-control means six things. Vacha vegam, manasa vegam, krodha vegam, jihva vegam, udara vegam, upastha vegam. So the three of them can be easily remembered. That is tongue, belly and genitals. We are in one line. Controlling the tongue means eat only prasadam. Eat pure food moderately. Don't eat excessively. And belly means control the belly. That means overeating is no good. And genital means sex life. But student means you should see every woman as a mother. Matravat paradareshu. When you become 26, 27, 28, at that time it's a marriageable age. Then you can get married at the time with the blessing of the parents. And otherwise one should not unnecessarily chase after any woman. You are not going to marry anybody now. You are too young now for marriage. So when marriage age comes, think about marriage now. Don't connect with boyfriend, girlfriend, all these things will ruin your academics completely. Do the right thing. Now your right thing is to study well, become a good devotee, and the right time comes. Some boys will tell you, hey, if you go to Hare Krishna, they will make you Sadhu Baba. But what about Arjuna? Was Arjuna a Sadhu Baba? Arjuna actually heard from Krishna directly. He heard Bhagavad Gita. After that, what he did? Did he wear saffron dress and go to ISKCON temple? He's a family man. He's a married man. And he has wives, he has children. By hearing Bhagavad Gita, you don't become Sadhu Baba. In fact, even Prabhupada himself was a grihastha. He had 5 sons. He raised a family. After he crossed, 60, then he took sannyas and everything. So, in our ISKCON organization, 99.9% of the people are married people. In our Pune community, we have about 6,000 grihasthas, married people. Only 100-150 brahmacharis. It's a small percentage. 1% or 2% people are sadhus. So, your friends actually try to dissuade you from becoming a devotee of Krishna because they themselves don't want to do. They don't want you also to do. They want to degrade. They want to unko narak mein jana, unko saath mein leke jayenge aapko bhi. They don't want to go alone. So instead, you should pull them to come to Krishna. Instead of they taking you down, you take them up. That is your duty as a devotee. So, and self-control also includes vachavegam, what we speak. Many of you, you have experience in the college, people speak gali, dirty words and all. But after you become Krishna devotee, we don't speak dirty words. And we don't do useless talk. Useless talk leads to arguments. Arguments lead to debate. Debate leads to fault finding and blasphemy. These are all increasing degree of bad speech. So everything begins with useless talk. If you don't talk about Krishna, you are going to talk about useless things about the world. So therefore, self-control includes beginning a speech. See, our tongue is like a rudder in a ship. In a ship, there's a tongue type of thing. You've seen that below? When the captain moves that, the tongue kind of thing slightly moves, the whole direction of the ship is changed. Similarly, this one tongue, it does 2 activity. Eating prasad, speaking. If you put prasad inside, then Krishna conscious speech will come outside. If you are putting non-prasad, that which is not offered to Krishna, then we also may speak things which are no good for us. So, therefore control the tongue. Vacho vegam, manasa vegam. Our mind has too many dirty demands. If you go on fulfilling the mind's demands, you will go mad actually. Therefore, we have to know the art of telling no to the mind. Hey, this is nonsense. Forget it. So, and the best way to say, chastise the mind is to chant little extra rounds. When our mind is too much troubling, 2 more rounds you chant. Mind will get frightened. Because manastayate iti mantraha. A mantra, you can control the mind very easily. And krodha vegam. Unnecessarily, one should not hurt others by harsh speech or by unnecessary anger towards others. Anger is called momentary madness. And anger is called one letter short of danger. Anger. So because if you become angry, anger has actually made people lose their relationships, best of friendships. Anger has caused war between nations. Anger has made a gentlemanly person lose his reputation. Anger has led people even to do murder, up to the point of murder. So uncontrollable anger. Sometimes we bring a machine gun for a mosquito, you say, no? For a small problem, we use excessive anger unnecessarily, atirosh. It's no good. So, vacha vegam, manasa vegam, krodha vegam, jihva vegam, udara vegam, upasthi vegam. This is self-control. And next one is self-respect. Self-respect means you don't feel inferiority complex. You know that Krishna, God has created everybody with some unique talents. A little story I'll tell you. Once a rat was making sound. Like he was making sound. And that was disturbing the sleep of a lion. Lion, whether he caught him in his hand. And the rat was like trembling. Sorry, sir, sorry, sir. And the lion said, you have disturbed my sleep. If I want, I can put you in my mouth and into my belly. But you are such a tiny creature, you will go to one corner of my belly. You are not fit even for my breakfast. Like that the lion said. Sir, please spare my life, spare my life. I will be of use to you later, he said. Lion laughed and said, you tiny creature, you will be useful to me. Anyway, I feel pity when you beg me. I will spare your life. Get lost. But another day, the lion was caught in a net. And the lion was trying his best to come out by shaking his body. He just couldn't come out. At that time, the rat came and said, sir, would you like my service? And the lion said, do it immediately before anybody comes and catches me. So the rat went round and round and cut with his teeth. Steel wires were there, he cut. And it saved the lion. So, you can see the rat is tiny, lion is great, king of the jungle. But the rat came to help of the lion. You can see that. Because God has given the rat a unique ability of a teeth to cut things, which lion doesn't have that. Lion couldn't escape himself. So, in the same manner, you may be small or you are big, you have to identify your unique potentials. Krishna gifted potential. There are 7 type of intelligences called Slimbil, S-L-I-M-B-I-L. S stands for spatial visual, which means you are very good in painting and all. And L stands for linguistic. You are very good in multiple language knowledge. I stands for intrapersonal, which means you are very philosophical, contemplative. You can actually be in R&D, where you can innovate creatively and intrapersonal. Then M stands for musical. You may be very good in music. You have sense of raga, tala, swara and all that. And B stands for bodily kinesthetic. You are very good in sports like athlete or table tennis or football or things like that. And I stands for interpersonal. You are very good in connecting with people. And last one, L stands for logical, mathematical. You are smart in maths. And there's one more thing added, which is N, which is natural. Natural means some people are very smart in knowing what is good for eco-friendly lifestyle and in aligning with nature. So totally 8 type of intelligences. So these last category people, they go for teaching yogasanas. They go for, natural, organic cultivation, cow protection, all those things they go for. Modern times, that's a very big field nowadays. So you identify which one God has gifted you, and then you strengthen. That is called core competency, we call it, or situational leadership. Like in water, tortoise is the leader. On land, rabbit is the leader. So you find out where are you leader, and that is Krishna's gift, and that will give you self-respect. You will never feel timid or good for nothing. Everybody has something to offer. That's why our Prime Minister of India started Skill India. Because he says that it is useless to earn degrees from the college which don't fetch any jobs. Out of 18 lakh engineers, only 3 lakh, 4 lakh people are getting jobs. Other 3, 4 lakh people go for masters. Other 10 lakh people don't have jobs. They are suffering without jobs. So therefore, he is starting with Skill India. Learn a skill which is natural for you, God gifted for you. And flourish in your life, you can have monopoly in that field. So actually in this way, in the Vedic life, Varnashrama means Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra, these 4 things. Tata, T-A-T-A, teachers, administrators, traders, artisans. So teachers, like myself, I wanted to be a teacher in my life of Bhagavad Gita. So last 30 years, I am studying and teaching and I have no worry at all. It's a very joyful life because this is what I felt Krishna has gifted me with. To understand the scripture, study scripture and give it to the people, and people are happy and I feel deep satisfaction also. Somebody's administrator, somebody wants to join army, or somebody wants to be a MBA and then he want to become entrepreneur and run a company. Somebody may be able to do that. Or somebody may be in governance also. Somebody may be IAS officer, collector or MLA, MP. That is also administration. And somebody is a trader means business, like cow protection, krishi goraksha vanijyam vaishya karma swavajam, cow protection, trading and farming, cultivating and producing crops. Many of you may be farmers' sons from villages. You may have the talent. Nowadays is a big market for organic foods. Organic cultivators are earning much more than even big engineers and doctors now. And similarly, artisans means somebody is a good labor. He is very hardworking. That is natural for him. So, and this will give self-respect if one identifies one's core competency. And the good manners. I already told you about good behavior. Read the next one.
Talking productively, proper utilization of time and punctuality.
Yeah. Actually, we should learn from Shastra and we should also have worldly wisdom. And we should speak usefully for us, usefully for others, and not unnecessarily gossip about others behind their backs, bad mouth about others, or talk about sports, talk about movie stars, things which don't produce any good in your life. And people generally talk about 2 subject matters. One thing is about woman, another one about money. how to escape income tax, famous talk. And who is that new girl who has joined as a secretary of her manager? What is her name? Which place she is from? What are her hobbies? Is it very important? You'll die without knowing it. So this is what is the interest. So we should talk productively and not talk useless things. And then proper utilization of time. So one should know time management. Right from the time I rise in the morning until the time I go to sleep. Every moment should be accounted like a gold coin. Ayusha kshana ekopi nalabhya swarana koti bihi. One moment should not pass without accounting. In my life also, in the morning, whole morning, I am in morning program, 4:30 to 9:30. And after that, every moment, I know which moment, who is going to come, what meeting I will have, what emails I have to do, and what preparations I have to do for the program. So we don't waste time. Krishna conscious devotee means avyartha kalatvam. One moment should not go without accounting. And then punctuality also saves time. Like in our college days, we had one punctuality seminar. So time management and punctuality, that was the topic. So the seminar presenter came 5 minutes late. So everybody was wild on him. So he told us, I know students, you all will be angry with me for coming 5 minutes late, but this is a part of the exercise, he said. Why I have come late? He said, you are 300 of you sitting. By coming 5 minutes late, I have successfully wasted 5 into 300, he said. 1500 minutes I have wasted. So I purposefully came late to teach all of you. You should never do like this. Just as I irritated all of you, you will irritate so many others when you are late, and you will lose your job in the interview if you go late, as he was telling. So we don't waste others' times, our time or others' time also. In India, people, if you get 5 o'clock, you call for a meeting, they come at 5:30. It's very, very bad. So this IST, Indian Standard Time, means half an hour late. Don't do that. Actually, therefore, if you're doing deity worship, in our boys centers, we have the altar where one boy worships different days. Dot 4:30 or 5 means you have to be there. You should have taken bath and you are wearing a thing for your two pujari service. So you are taught how to be clean, how to be punctual, how to do things on time. The shank has to be blown at a particular time. Read the next one.
Sense of responsibility towards society.
That I spoke about, like towards the youths and the cows and all, I said. Next.
Obedience to God and Guru, respect towards others.
If we don't show our obedience to Krishna and Guru, we are not going to make progress in spiritual life. What is because spiritual life? Even if you want to learn karate or kung fu, even if you want to learn Bharatanatyam or Hindustani music or anything, or even if you want to do some M.Tech thesis or doctorate thesis, if you don't respect those who have already achieved success in that field, if you don't become their ideal follower, if you don't adore them, and if you don't take their instructions into account, you cannot flourish in that field. Even material field also. In spiritual field, it's all the more. Because in material field, you can figure out something. Spiritual field, nothing you can figure out. Spiritual field, we are totally dependent on their mercy. Because they have practiced many, many years sincerely, and they have gone to great heights in spiritual life. We need their direction, we need their instruction, we need their chastisement, we need their correction, we need their enlightenment, we need their role model example. So respecting Acharyas na parapara, Mahajano yena katha sappanta, is very, very important. Prabhupada is our hero, who is a founder Acharya of this society. And then we have Prabhupada's disciples, who are also very great role models for us, great heroes also. So we have to follow in their footsteps, obedience to Guru and Krishna. And then
purity, respect to honesty.
Respect towards others also, which I already told you. Next.
Purity, honesty, truthfulness, integrity.
And these are all personal values, I told you. Next.
Humility, gratitude, courage to face unpleasant situations maturely.
Correct. Humility means amanitvam. Actually, we don't think very high about ourselves. We think, I am a tiny creature. I am a tiny tot. There are so many other people better than me. You know, I am insignificant speck. So this is the way devotee thinks. Not anxious to be honored by others. That is humility. Like one time I asked his wellness Bhakchar Maharaj, Maharaj, is humility a cultivable quality? Or is it inborn quality? I asked him. So he said, you can cultivate humility, possible. I asked him how. He said, you have to learn to see how great Krishna is and how small we are, he said. Then I asked him, how can we digest that? Many times we hear lectures, but we are unable to digest it. So then he told the story of Akbar and Birbal. One day Akbar took a chalk in front of all his ministers and drew a line and asked them, can any of you make this line small? I'll give you a big reward. So all the ministers came forward to rub the line. No, you cannot touch the line. Without rubbing it, you have to make it small. Then everybody said, sorry, sir, that's impossible. How can you make this much, a 1 meter long line? How can you make it small without rubbing it? If you have to make it half a meter, you have to rub it off. Everybody brought a duster. He said, no, you can't rub it, he said. Then when Birbal arrived in the court, Akbar called him and told him something. Birbal said, that's a very easy thing. I can, without touching your line, I can make it small. He said, how? He took the chalk and drew another line, just 3 times longer. You know, and everybody understood this became small. Everybody laughed. Hey, smart fellow. Huh? Similarly, Maharaj was telling, now we are thinking, I am very big. We think ourselves this much big, 1 meter long or something. And when you understand Krishna's greatness, I showed you all Vishwarupa Darshan, correct? No? After seeing that, and God is so great, we become small. Huh? We can become humble. Yeah. So really gratitude to mother, to father, to teachers, to Krishna for all the gifts that we have received. We should never forget. God gives, gives and forgives. We get and forget. No? It is said. And the Pandavas faced unpleasant situations maturely. They tolerate. They had tolerance and patience. No? Yeah. Read the next box.
Sensitivity, non-violence, concern for others.
Yeah. We should all be satisfied with ourselves and sensitive to others. This is the quality we have to cultivate. When it comes to others, we should be very sensitive. Like for example, I went for one program, to give a program. So the program was between 7 to 9. You know? So when 7 o'clock we went, some devotees had gone with me. And they said, Prabhu, we'll finish the prasadam early, 7 o'clock only, so that program gets over at 9, we can immediately leave. Yeah? I agreed, that's a good idea, because program in the beginning, everybody doesn't come. People come slowly. So they ate the prasad. And program got over at 9 o'clock. Immediately they said, hey, come quickly. We all sat in the sumo. But driver was not there. We were wondering, hey, where is the driver? And then our devotees ran out to check. And the driver, that is the time he went to eat. 9 o'clock. Big crowd of people were there for prasad, for him to make his line and sit. By the time we left the house, it was 9:40, 9:45. So what was the mistake? Because they forgot to feed the driver. If you fed the driver at 7, now everybody can leave at 9. So we should not only be, taking care of ourselves, we should take care of those who come with us also. Sensitive to others. Huh? Will he not be hungry? Poor fellow, every day he eats at 7, today he had to eat at 9, 9:30. Huh? So even though driver may be, we may consider him ordinary, employee or somebody, but we should have sensitivity to other people. Huh? Yeah. One driver was driving my spiritual master. In one very big car. 2 hours he drove him. After we all got down, my special master looked at the driver who came from that side. He came from this. Thank you. You drove very well, he said. And after my special master went to the program, this driver said, in my life, I have rarely heard people telling me, thank you. He said, people generally think drivers are not that important people. So, therefore, sensitivity to others is very important. And non-violence towards other creatures. Unnecessarily, we should not injure others by our harsh speech or harsh actions. And we should have concern for others. And next box.
Friendship, team spirit, cooperation, leadership.
This is very important. We should always be friendly with other fellow mates, rather than bringing our ego. So one boy was wearing a t-shirt here in our Hyderabad temple I saw here. He said, live echo, leave ego. That was written in the t-shirt. Live echo friendly, echo, and leave ego, he said. So actually, if you can have ego friendly relationships with others, people will be so happy. We should be unassuming, we call it. Unassuming, friendly, courteous, kind, cooperative, free from false pride. So if people see that he is a simple devotee, he is a very humble devotee, he is grateful and he is always appreciative of others, encouraging others. You know, he is very you know, devotee with golden heart, then people like to be friends with such devotees. And also team spirit means work as a team. You know the word team, no? Together everyone achieves more. T-E-A-M. Together everyone achieves more. That is team spirit. That is 1 plus 1 should be 11. Not that 1 and 1 cancel and become 0. You know, like 5 people in a boat are rowing the boat like this and you row the boat like this behind. Then it cannot move only. Everybody should move in the same direction. That's team. Like when you are staying in the student center, you will get training for all these qualities. How to be a good team player. And how to cooperate. There are 5 type of leaders. The 5th degree leader is one, you know, he's an individual player. He can't work with others, like a lion or a tiger. They can only work individually. And the 4th level leader is a team player, like ants. He can work in a team very well. 3rd degree leader is a team leader. Team leader means not only he can work in a team, he can lead a team, you know, identify the good abilities in individuals and pull them all up and put them in a forward direction to fulfill the purpose of the team. That is the 3rd level leader. So 5th level leader is a individual player. 4th level is a team player. 3rd one is a team leader. And the 2nd level leader is such a team leader, he can even engage weaklings very powerfully to fulfill the goal of the team. And that 1st level leader is a visionary leader. He can engage thousands of people. Thousands and thousands of leaders he can engage by giving them the... Actually, such a leader will have all these qualities. A leader who has all the qualities you are talking now, Yudhishthir Maharaj was such a leader. If you see Ambarish Maharaj, they are all great leaders. Parikshit Maharaj, Arjuna, Kaya, Prithu Maharaj. You read in the Srimad Bhagavatam. These people were having the whole world as one state. And they were only singular king for the whole world. Nowadays, every country has prime minister, president and all. In those days, the whole globe was ruled by one king only. Of course, below the king, there were thousands of kings, but all the kings happily saluted them and paid them tribute. That was their power, you see. So, that is the topmost leader. So, tomorrow when you come, I will continue. Now, I have shown you the slide, one slide I have shown you. Tomorrow, I will show you many examples and there are a few things we will see. And then I will tell you more about the voice center, JTH Gurukul, in comparison to the traditional Gurukul, which has been there in the ancient times. And you all have the opportunity, in case you were in Varanasi and in Kanpur colleges, and some of you may be from other places also, in case you have a center. Originally, when we started it in way back in 2000, we used to call it BASE, Bhaktivedanta Academy for Culture and Education. And later on in 2003, I had renamed it as VOICE because Vedic Oasis for Inspiration, Culture and Education. These are basically like youth hostels near the college, at a stone's throw from the college, where you can stay with devotees, you can rise early in the morning, you can cultivate all these qualities. You will learn everything there. You will learn cooking, cleaning, washing, and then singing songs, playing mridanga, playing kartals. And you will also be given some leading, some services, some departments will be given to you. And you will also be taught public speaking, how to present a lecture. And you will also be taught how to do coordinate teams and groups, how to organize a program, how to speak lectures in colleges, and also how to distribute Prabhupada's books, and how to run a center, lead a center. All this, many, many things will be taught to you there, with all these qualities which you heard today. So we have hundreds of centers in India like this, all over the country. Earlier in Pune, this model was originally started in 1996. At that time, there was no name given. Name was given in 2000. So eventually, I saw that this kind of centers are very effective. And near the college, boys have to stay in the hostel and eat meat, and they're drinking wine and getting spoiled with other friends. Whereas these youth hostels are pure places. Near the college, where it's almost like a ISKCON temple, it is. It's like youth hostel. There's a beautiful study room where there's a silent room. You can study well. Many of our boys are 9.5, 9.6 they get because they study very well in a focused manner. and eat pure prasadam. Morning they all do namaskar to each other, vacha kalpataru vesha. They are respectful to each other. They dance in kirtans and sing kirtans, and it's a very beautiful lifestyle it is. So we will learn more tomorrow about it, and we'll take some questions also tomorrow. Now it's time up now today. Shri Prabhupada ki, thank you very much.
Hare Krishna. So let us thank Prabhuji for so wonderfully explaining to all of us the qualities of which we will all learn as you all shift in the voice centers. I hope all of you must be very excited tomorrow for tomorrow's session also. Let us thank Prabhuji by loudly chanting one time. Hari Bol. Thank you, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. So there is some announcement for all of you, so kindly wait. So today we had this Jet Age Gurukul session, and tomorrow Prabhuji will continue this. On Sunday we have scheduled a session, that is faith and doubt session. So in these faith and doubt session, you have to share from your side, we'll share you a link where you have to share your faith, ki what gives you faith on a particular topic and what gives you doubt on that topic. So our first topic is that the topic's name is science and spirituality. Okay, so in science and spirituality, what gives you faith, you can share that, and what gives you doubt, so you can share that also. So Chaitanya Charan Prabhuji will be coming on Sunday, and he will be answering all of your questions, and he'll be speaking something and then answering all of your questions there. And like that, we have three topics. So first topic is science and spirituality. Second topic is scriptures. So what gives you faith and what gives you doubt in scriptures? And third topic is process of devotional service. The same, faith and doubt. So every topic will go for 2 days. So we will be having two more weeks for our Utkarsha, basically. And tomorrow Jet Age Gurukul, and then Sunday Chaitanya Charan Prabhuji will be taking. And on the next Friday, he will be continuing. And then Radhisham Prabhuji will be taking the further sessions, faith and doubt on scriptures and process of devotional service. So you can ask your superiors also if you have some more doubt. So basically, I have sent you a link. You can see, I will send this message to you again. So you can see this link and copy this and save this so that you all can write your faith and doubt here. Okay. So this is my message. Please see this. In the last, there is a link for sending the faith and doubt on the first topic, that is science and spirituality. All right. I hope it is understandable to you, all of you. Okay. So this is all for today. Please send it by tomorrow, end of the day, all your faith and doubt on this topic of science and spirituality. Hare Krishna. This is all for today. We will meet you tomorrow at 4 o'clock. As tomorrow is Saturday, so we'll meet at 4 o'clock. Hare Krishna.